that Sunday. It was, we remember the fathers of the church. Fathers of the church who taught the gospel, who taught the faith. Then we celebrate the feast of Pentecost. And right after Pentecost, this is the first Sunday after Pentecost, we celebrate All Saints. And so again, before Pentecost, Sunday before Pentecost, the fathers who taught the Orthodox, the faith that church keeps the message of Jesus. Pentecost gives, we remember that Christ gives us the gift from above, the Holy Spirit. And today we remember that those who receive this message and keep the Holy Spirit become saints. And we remember today all saints of the church. It is also celebration of the church because it is celebration of the saints. But because it is celebration of the church, who is the church? It is all of us. It is celebration of us. Feast of holiness, which we receive from God. And the image which, in which we are here reminds us about this. We are standing together. First of all, we responded, all of us who are standing in this holy temple, we responded to the invitation of Christ. Each of us is invited and responded to invitation of Christ to be participants in his holy supper, divine liturgy, and holy communion. And so here we are, standing in this holy temple, and the image that this temple gives us affirms what we believe. If we look up, we see our Lord Jesus giving blessing and overseeing us, us uniting all of us together. Then Jesus is surrounded by archangels, by cherubims, by archangels, and then as it goes down, he is surrounded by the 12 apostles, then four gospel apostles who wrote the gospels, and then we are surrounded by all the saints who were painted on the walls of this holy temple. And that is not all yet. And then we are gathered, all of us gathered by Christ, united in Christ, continuing this image of this holy people from the walls and standing here presently before Christ himself. And Christ is present in our midst. This is the image. This is the actually reality in which we are. And so celebration of all the saints, it is celebration of each and every one of us who is holding to Christ, who lives his, her faith in Christ. And so again, if we look at the way how the feasts are structured in the church, you look at our church calendar, Pentecost, holy gift of the Holy Spirit is given by Christ from above to all of us. We become the church, the living church, receiving the message of Christ and the Holy Spirit. And the church produces the holy people. And who is the saint, if we ask a question? We may look at the lives of the saints who did great deeds, and think we are little people with little power, little willpower, nothing can be compared to them. So we have a tendency to belittle ourselves and think that saints are those somebody great warriors of in spirit of faith, and we just try to do what we can. But in reality, the saint is a person who lives in Christ, nothing more. The saint is not that person who makes miracles. Remember what Apostle Paul says about divine love. We can possess all the gifts, we can speak even angelic languages, many different languages, we may do great miracles, but if I lack divine love, I am nothing. And so, to possess this divine love, it is possible only if my life is rooted in Christ. And this is the holy life. This is how a person becomes a saint. Also, if we look, when we talk about holiness and saints, the holiness is shown to us in its fullness when we read the Holy Gospel, when we look at Christ himself, life of Christ. When we think about holiness, we think it's something filled with light, goodness, everything is good. But when we read the Gospel, it is filled with tragedy, right? If we just look at the life of Christ, as a life of Christ, we read more and more in the Gospel, he becomes more and more persecuted and not acknowledged. And eventually, he is put on the cross, and not just put on the cross, but he faces his death. Because of what? Because of holy life. And so, when we talk about holiness and saints, it is always tragic. It is never triumphant in its pure form. It is filled with tragedy because life in this earthly life is filled with light and darkness, with evil and goodness, with holiness and presence and action of evil against this holiness. But holiness overcomes this evil and darkness only if we become the image of Christ and copy Christ in our actions, in our life. We fight evil only by goodness and by holiness, by the cross. This is how the holiness is expressed. And so, brothers and sisters, church reminds to us today and remembers all the saints, reminds us that we are called to be the saints. We are on the way to holiness. Holy liturgy, divine liturgy is structured, showing us and leading us step by step closer to Christ and receiving his divine power from above, nourishing ourselves with divine food, the Holy Communion. And so for us to live a holy life is to live our life in Christ, but to live our life, in order to live our life in Christ, we need to follow his commandments, respond to the Holy Gospel, and live in communion with the Holy Altar. If you ask me what is to live in communion with the Holy Altar, it is very simple, to live in communion with the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist, to be participants of Christ through the sacrament which Jesus left to us and gave us in order to nourish us, to have this divine power, power of holiness. And so, as one priest said, to be a member of the church, it's not a waste of time, right? Because church produces the saints. And if we fully immerse ourselves in the life of the church, it's not a waste of time. It is a fulfillment of the ultimate aim of our life, to become together with Christ, with our Lord. And that makes us holy. So let us be responsive to the call of Christ, just like the saints did, just like the mother of our Lord did, who responded, "I am the servant, handmaid of God, be it according to your will." And so let us do our best to do the will of God in our life. And that makes us holy. Amen.